Hey friends, it's Brian and I'm going to be working on my junky truck. So what I'm going to do in this video is remove this alternator. Goodbye. It's going to go away. Not that it's bad. Pulley doesn't look that great, but the issue here is this is a 1G alternator and it has a external voltage regulator. And something doesn't work. Doesn't charge batteries, so it's going to go away. And I'm going to upgrade it to a 3G internal regulator alternator. So, let me get started. Alright, so first order of business here is to remove the battery. And that's not going to work, so let me go get a wrench. Alright, so now that we've got a 9/16 wrench. I can't think of a good practical way to isolate the battery, so I'm just going to take it offline. That way I don't run the risk of creating a short while I'm working on this. Where that went. Fell at my feet, which was a nice change, so it's really easy to deal with. That comes off. That's it. Had a little piece that tried to escape. Okay, so that's out. Now, what's holding this in? Alright, looks like it's a quarter inch. I just gotta find a ratchet for that. I'll be right back. Alright, this is a 5/16 bolt. Alright, no idea what that went to. Alright. We'll just start by unplugging it. Let's go see what the other end of this actually goes to. So the other end goes to the air conditioner. That looks like it's the last surviving thing. That's on. Okay. And I've got a couple sensors that are still on here. Air conditioning clutch, so that's two wires. I gotta take all this apart before I'm gonna be comfortable answering what else is left on here. So that's gonna be kind of a larger project than what I wanna take on tonight. I might start. Let me go get the trash can. I'll be right back. Alright, so I've added a headlamp. Hate split loom. because it's very, very difficult to put on and very, very difficult to get rid of. It traps dirt. More that needs to occur over here. Let me go get some nipper. This isn't exactly what I wanted, but I think this will work. No, those are too big. Okay. Alright, so that's out. Now, we've got yellow wire and a green wire coming out. This wire is actually in pretty good shape, but it is 100% necessary to rewire this if I want to make the modification the way I want to make it. Every excess wire that's not used is a liability. Thank you.
vacuum hose over top of this was an idiot. Looks like. Disconnect this. There we go. Make this much easier to mess with. So now what we're left with, alternator, and a couple of stray sensors. If you're only interested in the alternator project, I'm done with the alternator piece of this. I'm just stripping down the wiring harness so that I can put it in a different loom. I'm gonna run it with these other wires, and I'm gonna pull power for the, well, no, those are controls for the glow plug, so that's not gonna work. But I am gonna run everything along one new harness, and it will not be where this one is. Nope. But I am going to go ahead and film this because it might help somebody else. It hurts my hands, but that's to be expected. you end up pulling the scrap out of here one little flaky plastic piece at a time. There's a lot of really bad wiring that's been done on this truck, so I want to inspect every piece of wiring in this engine bay so that I know that it's all done properly. This looks like factory work here. Stupid there. This can stay. Well, It's probably not going to... Just leave it alone. So we want to keep this. Well, I don't know. There may not be much worth keeping here. This is so fried from the heat. But we'll try. Yeah, I don't think there's enough left of this. So save it and toss it. All right, so.
This.
All right, that's it for tonight. Thanks for watching. I hope you found this helpful, inspirational maybe. And the next project will be to install and wire the new radiator, new alternator. Although I may take advantage of the fact that I have better access than I'm gonna have at any other point. Do I want to replace these hoses while I have just the best access ever to them? I think the answer to that is yes, because I got good access to this one, got good access to that one. So I may take a detour and replace some hoses in the morning while I've got all this crap open and accessible. Again, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video, and I hope it's been helpful to you. One of the next steps is going to be to secure and wire wrap all this wire. Keep it safe and out of the way. That's on my shit list, too. I want to replace that. I don't like that copper line. So much junk, so little time.